Hello dear watercolorists, and thank you so much for watching this video. Today I'm gonna be making a dog portrait, and for that I've been using the photo of one of my friends. It's a low-key photography, and this is actually my favorite type of photo to work with because the proportion of values is already correct in the photo, so I don't have to go ahead and calculate and make a lot of small test sketches to determine the values. A good successful painting has about 90% darks and just 10% of very bright areas, and that is how you're gonna focus the view of the observer, have more clarity, and we'll make that light area very precious. So for this painting, I decided to use a hot pressed paper. It's an arches, and the reason why I chose this is because I am working delicate on the eyes and the nose, and I want to have more details in that area. Also, the hairs that I'm gonna show, the light hairs against the dark background, I want to make them as sharp as possible. And the way I'm gonna work on the background is I want to have soft areas and sharp areas. And I'm using this water sprinkler to soften some of the areas and also give more moisture so that my pigment flows in a more natural way. And I'm trying to have an even coverage, but also show the lighter part. The lighter zone would be in the bottom of the painting. So I'm using here a very wide 2-inch thick flat brush, and now I'm switching to a silver brush. Very pointy tip, and this is the moment when I am deciding consciously what focus areas are. Where my focus area is, that's where the hairs are going to be very sharp, and the rest of the areas are going to be soft. So I'm going to have a wet on wet work, basically. And I'm sprinkling some water now after the first layer is completely dry to go ahead and apply the colors for the fur. And I'm trying to spread it evenly but not rub it too much, but because that when you're gonna drag out your pigment from the background, and you don't want that to happen. Now for this part, I'm using combination between Naples yellow and yellow ochre with my mop brush, and I'm trying to not focus on details right now and just notice what are the darker areas, and I'm putting the first layer on. At this stage, I don't want any sharp edges because the painting will look very tight, and I'm not looking for that specific look on this painting. Note that I'm using this paper, scrap paper, to test the values before I put them on my final painting. Using here ultramarine blue combined with cerulean. It's a mix that is not too warm, and I think it works very well. This is gonna be the cold sections of the fur, and that's gonna contrast with the warmth of the yellow I've used before. At this stage, I'm still working wet on wet, so I am softening the edges of each brush stroke, and now I am applying even a darker tone, and for this I used the ivory black from Daniel Smith. I'm combining multiple brands of watercolor here, and I'm not focusing so much on having exactly the same set to use. I've been doing that in the past, using only Schmincke or only Winsor & Newton, but I find that some of the shades that I'm looking for, I can't find for one brand, so then I just use whatever I have in my collection. And now I've been working more on details here, and I'm trying to soften some areas, and for that I'm using a bigger brush. This is a mop, it's with natural hairs. I think it's red sable. It's not very important. The only thing that I'm paying attention right now is to have a soft brush. I don't want to have more texture. I want to soften things. So I need a very fine brush. Now I'm working on the details for the eyes, and I took some of the masking fluid off because I had some fur made with the masking fluid, and also the whites of the eyes I preserved, and the white of the shininess of the nose, it's 100% the white of the paper, and I want to cover that, the white zones. Now I'm adding more and more contrast, squinting my eyes, looking at the photo and trying to pick what are other dark areas, and that's gonna create a nice shape and a more 3D image of the portrait. Final touches I'm adding with the dry brush. Now you can see while the background is drying, we have the streams that gives a nice texture, and this is how it looks like from up close. I think I'm happy with it, and I hope you guys enjoyed it and you learned a few tricks on how to do the fur and the interesting texture background, and just overall gives you an idea on how to do a pet portrait. If you guys liked it, please subscribe and like this video, and I'll see you on the next one. Happy painting!